Hello, welcome to the course on audio signal processing for music applications. This week we are presenting diverse spectral modeling strategies to model sounds. And one of the underlying concepts that we are introducing is the idea that there are many sounds that are not quite well modeled with sinusoids or with a harmonic analysis approach. That there are signals that are very noisy, that are what we call stochastic, that require a different modeling approach. That is, this modeling approach is based more on statistical signal processing, on describing the sound from a probabilistic point of view. So in this programming class, I want to go over that from a programming perspective, so present the models that we have been implementing in the SMS tools, and that implement this idea of stochastic modeling. So we'll basically be talking about this block diagram, in which we start from a signal, and then after windowing it and computing the FFT, we just keep the magnitude spectrum. In stochastic signals, the phase spectrum is not relevant, and so the approximation is based on the magnitude spectrum. That then it's approximated with a smooth curve, and this smooth curve is what we call the stochastic model. And from that we can reconstruct, or we can regenerate a signal by sort of reconstructing a magnitude spectrum, and then generating phases randomly, so that we can create another complex spectrum that captures some of the essence of the original sound. And then by overlap adding, we can generate a signal that hopefully, if the original signal had these stochastic properties, will be quite similar to the original sound. So let's go to text editor, and here I wrote a very short script that implements this idea of approximating a fragment of a sound with this stochastic model. Okay, so we start by importing a few packages that we need, and then the core of the code is basically reading a sound file. This is the ocean sound file that we already have been using, so it's clearly a stochastic type of signal. And then, in order to analyze the spectrum of it, we have to define the FFT size and the window size. In this type of sounds and this type of situation, there is no need to zero pad, there is no need to have an odd size window. So we have the M, the window size, and N, the FFT size, of the same size, which is 256. Then the key parameter is this what we call a stochastic factor, which is basically the smoothing factor, or the downsampling factor. So 0.2 in this case that we define, it means that we are basically reducing the information by a factor of 0.2 and getting only the kind of the surface information. Then we get the window. In this case, we get a humming window, but it can be any type of window. It doesn't have to be very complex. In fact, I would say that maybe it's easier to just use the humming because it's even simpler and it works. Okay. Then we need to select the portion of the sound we're going to analyze. So in this case, well, we chose a section in the sample 10,000. And then plus the window size, and we multiply it by the window. Then we compute the spectrum, and then we convert it to dB, and we do the approximation, the stochastic approximation, on the dB spectrum. And we do it by using this Python function called resample. Resample is a function that basically uses an FFT approach. So it uses a spectral analysis approach to downsample a signal, or to resample a signal. Both we can downsample or upsample a signal. So we give a function in this case MX, and we just make sure that there is nothing below minus 200 decibels. It wouldn't make any sense. And we specify the length, the new length that we want to create. So the original length was of size n over 2, because we are only using half of the spectrum. Okay, so from n over 2 samples, we are going to generate n over 2 multiplied by this stochastic factor approximation. So basically, if this is 0.2, we're going to have 1/5 of the samples that we started with. Okay, let's run this little script. So we'll run the test, and we can plot the signal that we start with, the windowed fragment that we start with. So this is the fragment of the ocean sound already windowed by a Hanning window. Okay, and then we are computing the spectrum of that. So the spectrum is this MX array. Okay, so this is the magnitude spectrum of that. And now we can plot on top of that the smooth approximation, or the downsample approximation of that, so which is MXM. But in order to make sure that it's shown on top of this array, which is a longer size, we have to plot it differently. So we have to say NP range of MXM, well, the size of that, and then if we divide by stock factor, this should stretch these points to the size that we had of the MX. Okay, so yes, so here we show in green the approximation, the smooth approximation. Of course, it has less samples, so MXM has the size of it is 25 samples. So from the 128 samples that the positive side of this magnitude spectrum has, we have reduced it to 25. Okay, of course, if we change the stochastic factor, we will do we will have more or less samples to be approximated. But clearly, this green line is an approximation to the blue line. Okay, so this is what the kind of a stochastic approximation that we're going to be using does. And now let's go to this other script, and what we will be doing is to actually synthesizing a sound from this. So we have the same first part up until here. Okay, so we generate the envelope, and now what we're going to do is to resample again the approximated spectrum, but to the size of n over 2, so that we get all the samples of the complete FFT. Then we will generate random numbers for the phase. And then to create the whole complex spectrum, we will have to deal with the symmetry, so that we will recreate the magnitude and phase for the negative frequencies, and of course convert it to complex numbers. So the positive spectrum, the positive complex spectrum, would be 10 to the power of the magnitude multiplied by the exponential of the phase. Okay. Well, this is, of course, the conversion from dB to linear scale. And then for the negative part, we do the same thing, but we reverse the order, and the phase is the negated of that. And then we just take the inverse FFT of the complex spectrum. So let's run this. This is test one. Okay. And in here we have the magnitude spectrum that we started, the MX. Okay, so this is the original spectrum. And now we can plot on top of that the approximated and but upsampled to have the same size. So in fact, MY has the same size than this. So now this green line started from the samples that we showed before, so it was more a jagged line and had fewer points, and now it has converted into a smooth version that has the same size than the original spectrum. And of course the phase spectrum, if we plot the PY, this is the phase spectrum that we generated, which is just random numbers from 0 to pi, so to pi. And by taking the inverse FFT, we can just obtain the output signal. So this is the synthesized signal from that approximated spectrum. Of course, this is different from the XW that we have started from. So now the green is the original signal we started from, clearly very different, but that's not the point here, because being stochastic signals, the shape in the time domain is not that relevant. What is important is this general distribution in the magnitude spectrum. Okay, so now let's look how the actual analysis and synthesis work for longer sounds. So in here we have the stochastic model.py file, in which we have different functions that implement the analysis of a complete stochastic signal and the synthesis from the analyzed stochastic representation. And basically they do what I have done for a single frame, in which the stochastic model anal, it starts from the signal, the hop size, the FFT size, and the stochastic factor, and it iterates over the whole sound, and it does what we just did. It performs FFT, it finds the dV magnitude spectrum, and then it uses the resample function to downsample it to fewer samples depending on the stochastic factor, and it keeps appending these to a sequence of envelopes, because we're going to have a time-varying envelope for the stochastic representation. And of course the synthesis does again what I showed before. It has to upsample the magnitude spectrum to the complete size, it has to generate the random faces, and then it has to convert to the complex spectrum and do the overlap at to recover the whole signal. So let's call these for a particular sound. So in here I wrote a little script that takes that ocean sound and it calls the stochastic model anal, so it analyzes the whole sound. Okay, and it uses a hop size of 128. The FFT size is used to be twice as that, so instead of specifying an FFT size, the default is normally to just take twice the hop size, and then there is the stochastic factor, which is 0.2. So now if we run this test 2, okay, now we have created a stock M that, if we look at the shape of that, that's a matrix that has 2,217 frames, and each frame has 25 points, which are the points of the approximation. And this we can look up individual frames, but basically what we normally do is we plot it with p color mesh, okay, the p color mesh, and we specify stock m will display this array like in a color, like 3D type of plot. Of course this is shown in the kind of the wrong direction. We are accustomed to see time in the horizontal axis, so what we normally do is show it with NP and transpose. Okay, so this will reverse the plot and it will show the x-axis in the as time and vertical axis as frequency. Okay, so this is the plot of the spectral representation of these coefficients of the stochastic representation. Okay, and let's now go to this function that basically does this stochastic analysis and synthesis for a complete sound, and at the same time it plots it nicely. This is the code that is used from the interface, and it plots a nice spectrogram of the stochastic representation. So in here we have this main function that has some parameters by default, and it reads the sound, it performs the analysis that we just did, and then it does the synthesis from the whole analysis, and then it outputs a sound file, and then it plots the different components, the input sound, the stochastic representation, and the output sound. So let's run these. We run the stochastic model function.py. Okay, and this plots input sound, the stochastic approximation, and the output sound. And of course, we can now it has saved a file called ocean-stochastic-model.wav, and I can just play it by taping play and ocean. Okay. Okay, so this has played the complete sound, and as we showed before, well, it's quite similar, even though it's not identical. It definitely sounds like an ocean sound, and even though it has lost some of the low frequencies, so we might have to change a little bit the stochastic approximation in order to recover the complete sound a little bit better. But anyway, okay, so that's what I wanted to present. So we talked about this stochastic model implementation that we have in the SMS tools package, and of course we use quite a bit of the Python functions from NumPy, SciPy, and also the plotting of Matplotlib. So we have seen how to implement the stochastic model that we talked about in class, in the theory class. And this will be one important component to then, now in the next classes, to incorporate it into the harmonic or sinusoidal plus a stochastic representation. So therefore, we'll be using this model to analyze the residuals that we obtain by subtracting the sinusoids or the harmonic. So I hope to see you next lecture. Bye-bye.